I'd like you to meet Ben. Ben was born 10 weeks premature. As you'd expect, at birth he was smaller than usual and remained in hospital for 4 weeks before being allowed to come home.
I took Ben for a routine examination at hospital. His consultant started manipulating his legs in a way that I knew wasn't right, showing some concerns. And it was at that point then he said that he thought Ben had cerebral palsy.
We turned to the authorities for help and they weren't forthcoming to begin with in the early stages with any help towards Ben's condition. It led to me giving up my job in the police service so I could help Ben and help Lorraine bring Ben up. We didn't know whether Ben was able to walk or talk or even feed himself in the early stages. And again, they said the authorities were not forthcoming at all with anything regarding our questions, were they?
We did look at different areas of help. We looked towards different sort of therapies and centres that could help with those sort of needs, really, because Ben was 6 months old. You have no idea of sort of his capabilities. It was difficult to attend the therapy centres. We went to two different ones, and it was very much parent led. So we struggled to, when we got back home, we didn't have the help of the centre as such. So we struggled with the exercises, and Ben's progress in some of these areas was very slow. And also financially, it was quite difficult, wasn't it?
Yeah, I mean, the financial burden was, it was costing us between £350 to £500 a week.
Lorraine and Rick tried to adapt the family to a new way of coping, every day doing whatever they could to give Ben a chance for the future.
Ben was nearly 2 years old. I filled on an online assessment form and I couldn't believe the difference because Megan Baker House phoned us straight away, invited us in for an assessment, and then asked Ben to come in for a 4 week block course. It was a great weight lifted off our shoulders because all of a sudden somebody else cared, didn't they?
That's right. Where others said that Ben wouldn't respond to everyday tasks or be able to complete everyday tasks, we found that the conductive rehabilitation gave us light at the end of the tunnel. There were some fairly noticeable improvements in the early stages with Ben, such as not being dependent on his dummy, and being able to construct small sentences, and being able to use his potty.
Staff at Megan Baker House use conductive rehabilitation to challenge the boundaries. And with Ben, they've taken those boundaries beyond what other people would have challenged them before, which has resulted in him being able to learn to eat fruit successfully. And he also interacts with other children really well now as well, doesn't he?
Yeah, Ben's at mainstream school now, and he's able to sit in assembly with the rest of his peers unaided, so he can sit on his own. We still feel there's a long way to go with Ben in order for him to be able to achieve the rest of the things that other children of his age can do.
We'd like Ben to continue at Megan Baker House. It offers him the best opportunity to learn to walk. Recently, when I took Ben to his first wheelchair appointment, and he was fitted for his wheelchair, he asked me, "Mummy, will you teach me to walk?" Which was a really heart-wrenching moment, obviously. And I think for us, Megan Baker House is a journey for us to achieve that long-term aim, and it's the best opportunity we have to do that.
What has the support that Megan Baker has given Ben mean to you?
It means that it's given us some focus and support in the first instance, but essentially it's meant that we can reach Ben and we understand Ben, and that the communication is there between us all and helped everyday family life, really.
I see I need help me walk.